Let's get that first. Ezekiel chapter 1. We're going to read 5 to 6.
The book of Ezekiel chapter 1 and verse 5. Also out of the midst thereof came the likeness of four living creatures.
So the four living creatures that Ezekiel seen came out of what? Came out of what, brothers? The chariots. Come on.
And this was their appearance.
Uh-huh.
They had the likeness of a man.
Uh-huh.
And every one had four faces.
Every one had four faces. Come on.
And every one had four wings.
Mm-hmm.
And their feet were straight feet.
Mm-hmm.
And the sole of their feet was like the sole of a cast foot.
Mm-hmm.
And they sparkled like the color of burnished brass.
So right there it tells you that the angels are black. That's a scripture right there that clearly tells you that the angels are black. Burnished brass. Burnished brass. So this is where this man, this Jewish man, who drew up this superhero, who came up with it. This is where they got the idea. All right, hit play again. The one verse 26, because it said that the living tribunal was older than the earth itself. Okay, or was, there's different sources that says it was created when the earth was created. All right, let's read that. Genesis.
Genesis chapter 1, verse 26. And God said, let us make man in our image.
You hear that? So God said, let us, the us there, is talking about plural gods, all right? Or also known as Elohim or Elohim. Okay, let us make man in our image. Now, what day was this? What day was man created? Officer Yaakov.
The sixth day.
The sixth day, so that means there were days prior. The earth already existed, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, it says, let us make man in our image. Come on.
After our likeness.
Uh-huh.
And let them have dominion over the fish of the sea.
All right, so that's when you go back to this character right here, the living tribunal. Not only was it a representation.
Praise him, all his angels. Praise him, all his hosts. Praise him, sun and moon.
Praise him, all ye stars of light. Praise him, ye heavens of heavens. And ye waters that be above the heavens.
Mm-hmm.
Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he commanded and they were created.
So the Most High spoke it and they were created. Come on.
He hath also established them forever and ever.
Mm-hmm.
He hath made a decree which shall not pass.
So he had made a decree that shall not pass. And the things that he established forever and ever was not only the heavens, the waters, the earth, but everything in it. Even above, all right, in the spiritual realm, all the angels that was created for the service of the Most High. All right, get me Hebrews chapter 1 and verse 14. Hebrews 1, chapter 1, verse 14.
Hebrews chapter 1 and verse 14. Are they not all ministering spirits?
So what is he talking about? He's talking about the angels. Are they not all what? Ministering spirits. Ministering unto whom? Unto the Most High God. Come on.
Sent forth to minister for them who shall be heirs of salvation.
Sent forth to minister for them who shall be heirs of salvation. What is that talking about?
Verse.
And if you were confused that it's talking about the angels, start at verse 13.
Verse 13. But to which of the angels said he at any time?
Mm-hmm. This is some powerful stuff right here coming out of the scriptures. The Bible says the angels minister unto us. Ain't talking about 144,000 amongst us.
In the book of Revelation.
The angels ain't ministering unto them at all.
Once.
Okay.
Us, so give me an example. 144,000 of us repeat and come back to the Lord.
Starting off for him. Asking him a question.
Everything go down.
It's talking about us going on.
Yeah. Until we repeat salvation. And get our shit. That's called grace.
Right.
That's the grace. Not for everybody.
Somebody else.
He's going to raise
the
up the
angels,
dead.
Come
too.
On. Even him. So not if they right. Don't repent, they're going to have us to death. We'll talk about the.
Oh, hell no.
This
shit deep.
World War
III. We're
going to
turn
all this thing about
that
shit. All of those things
slave,
activate
on whose
behalf. On our
behalf. We're going to turn their ass
into
slaves.
Isaiah
13. That's in the book of Revelation.
Satan that a regular
view of
the trouble of water and the ocean. The one above all is omnipotent, all powerful.
All powerful. Come on.
Omniscient, all knowing, and
all knowing. Come on.
Present everywhere.
Uh-huh.
His power is unlimited, incalculable, and immeasurable. His strength is unlimited, he cannot be damaged in any way, and he has control over all forms of energy. Because he's omnipotent, he wields every power. The one above all is often unofficially cited as
Stan Lee right there. Come on.
All's creators, Stan Lee and Jack Kirby.
So these are the guys who created the one above all. All right, you had Stan Lee and Jack Kirby, who I showed you earlier, are Jewish people. Come on. All right, that's it on that. So let's get omnipotent, all powerful, all powerful. All right, get me Job 11, 7 to 11. Job 11, 7 to 11.
Bro, you gotta read this shit, bro. You gotta start reading this shit, bro.
This is what the pastor
that's not telling us about the Bible, bro.
Canst thou be searching?
You go to
searching,
you
know, find out God. We'll have trouble getting to the second heaven. Unless you in a spaceship. Space. Then when you get to the second heaven, you try to get to the third heaven, you ain't gonna find it. Alright, come on.
What canst thou do? Mm-hmm. Or gather together? Then who can hinder him? For he knoweth vain men. He seeth wickedness also. Will he not then consider it?
So the Most High God's power is unlimited. That's why they call him omnipotent or omnipotent. It said, it is as high as heaven, what canst thou do? Deeper than hell, what canst thou know? The measure thereof is longer than the earth and broader than the sea. Get me omniscient, meaning he's everywhere. I mean all knowing, I'm sorry. Omniscient means he's all knowing. Get me Psalms 147, 4 to 5. So you'll write this down, right? Write omniscient in your book, which means all knowing. Okay, and then right next to it, you're gonna put Psalms 147, 4 to 5. All right? Come on.
The book of Psalms.
One of the brothers here.
She doing good, but she don't really know nobody over there like that.
That's why I ain't going over there.
Brother Dave.
Brother Dave, what is omnipresent?
As the day, the darkness and the light are both alike to thee. For thou hast possessed my reins. Thou hast covered me in my mother's womb. I will praise thee, for I am fearful and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, thine eyes did see my substance, yet being unperfect, and in thy book all my members were written.
Newly I formed thee in the belly. Before you were born, I knew thee. I formed thee. So in thy book all my members were written. In thy book all thy members were written. All the body parts, everything was written. So when you see a child born without a limb or a child born like...
Metro Boomin want some more, nigga.
Yeah. Yeah.